Hello friends, welcome to another session of video tutorials from Raj Tech Trainer. Please subscribe and share the videos on this channel. To subscribe to this channel, hit the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. Hello friends, welcome to another session of video tutorials on REST API using Postman. In today's session, we are going to cover workspaces, mock server and monitor. So this is the last video of this series. Let us begin with looking at workspaces. So this is an area where all your collections, requests, environments, monitors, mock servers are created. There are two types of workspaces available in this Postman. One is personal workspace, the other one is team workspace. Let us see one by one. Okay, let us open up Postman. So these are some of the earlier requests which I had. Okay, as you can see, this is my workspace. Okay, I can only see this when I log in. Currently, I have logged in. I have created a user and I logged in. Only after logging in, I see my workspace. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go ahead and create a new workspace. Okay. So here I'm going to create it as Raj Tech Trainer Workspace. Okay, since this is a personal one, so I'm going to create this workspace. Okay, so this is a new workspace where I can have all the requests, history of all the requests, and I can create a new collection. I can do everything whatever was covered under previous videos. Okay, so here what I will do is I will just send a request to get the list of projects in Redmine. I'll type in the URL to fetch the projects. So as soon as I click on send, so I got the response back. So this particular request will be stored under this workspace. Okay, if I go to the other workspace, so this request will not be available there. Okay, you don't see that here. I can also create a collection, I can also create an environment, I can also create a mock server, I can also monitor. So all these can be under this particular workspace. Okay, now what I will do is I'm going to go ahead and create a new team workspace. As I told earlier, there are two types. One is personal and the other one is team workspace. By default, you will have my workspace and team workspace. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new team workspace. Okay. So this is going to be a team workspace. I can also add the team members by entering their email ID and clicking on add. So currently I don't have any team members. I can also add it later on. I will go ahead and create this workspace. We'll try the same URL to fetch the project. Thank you. Okay, here I'm going to fetch only the first project. Okay, I'm clicking on send. That request gets registered under history. Okay, I can also have this collection. Okay, I'm going to call this as get collection. I'm going to save this under this collection. I can also invite other members to join this team workspace so that I can share it across them. So you can collaborate all the requests from other team members under one workspace. So this is the default dashboard for your user. Okay, under this, all the requests for different workspaces get synced in here. So let us see, let us go back and check. So currently, I have two workspaces here. This is the one which I created just now, Raj Tech Trainer workspace. And I had only one request under history. So let us see whether that gets updated. Yeah, it is getting updated here. And I don't have any environment configured. Monitors configured, I don't have mocks configured, integrations configured, or I don't have any activity configured. The same way I can also take a look at the team workspace. I'm going to go and select Raj Tech Trainer team workspace, which I created just now. Under collections, I created one collection called get collection. Under history, I have only one request which I sent out just now. And I don't have any environments configured, monitors. So if I had environments, monitors configured or mocks configured, I would have seen those here. So all those will be synced to your dashboard. So this is about workspaces. Now let us take a look at MockServer. So MockServer is a server which lets you simulate the real API using request response pace. That means it is going to create a server which will act as a mock server, wherein you can configure the endpoint as well as the response body. So let us see how to do it. So I'm going to create this under my personal workspace, Raj Tech Trainer. I need to go in here, click on new and select mock server. Okay, here, as I told earlier, so there is a request path and a response body which we need to provide. So this mock server can be used in real world when there is no API endpoint developed. So we just want to mimic what would be the response from the actual API server. Okay, so let us say in our case, let us say the admin is not created and I want to get the list of projects. Okay, I want to get the list of projects. So projects.json will be my endpoint, and a response body I will have. Okay, project one comma project two. Okay, and the same way I can also have another endpoint to get the users dot json, and here users will be bitnami. Okay, I'm going to click on next. Okay, configure mock server. So I have to give a name for this mock server. I'm going to give it as Redmine mock server. Okay, so if we have an environment which is already created, you can go ahead and select it here, but I don't have currently any environment set up. Okay, you can also make this server private or public. Click on create. So this is the URL which the postman creates for me to use. So this will be my base URL. As you can see, after creating the mock server, it has created those two requests. One is for projects and one is for users. I'm going to go ahead and click on one of the get requests and click on send. Whenever we create a mock server, it is going to create a environment also. So I have to select the environment as Redmine mock server and click on send. Now I get the response whatever I had configured earlier. The same goes with your users also. And click on this examples and click on default. Okay, I'm going to have this under pretty format in JSON format. So I can go ahead and save this. Okay, once I click on send again, so I should be getting the new response. Okay, so this is how we use mock server. Okay, let us take a look at monitor now. What is a monitor? A monitor lets you run requests periodically to check the performance and response time of all the requests. Okay, let us see how to configure a monitor. To configure a monitor, we have to click on new and then click on monitor. For this, I'm going to go ahead and use the request rest.in. From here, I'm going to pick up the API call, which is to get a single user. I'm going to copy this request. And then paste it here to check whether it still works. Okay, so this I'm going to copy it and paste it here. Okay, so what this will do is so this will monitor this particular request and checks the status, whether the status code contains 200 or not, and it also checks the response time, which is specified here. Okay, I click on next. Okay, I'm going to call it with some name. I don't have any environment set up now. So monitor run frequency, I'm going to say it as run it every hour. And the region which I'm going to specify is Asia Pacific. Okay, click on create. Okay, now the monitor is created. The monitor is located here. I can go ahead and check the results here. That will go to my dashboard. Okay, I'll come back to that later on. I click on close here. As soon as I created this monitor, it has created a new collection with one request in it. Okay, so let us take a look at the request. So under request, it has also created tests. Okay, so currently I have only one test, which is to check the response time, whether it is below 400 milliseconds or not. Okay, so I click on send. Let us see whether it works or not. I got the response back, but if you look at the test result, it has failed. So why it has failed? Because the response time it took was 1000 milliseconds, not 400. Okay, so now I go back to the dashboard. Okay, under this dashboard, since I am using this Raj Tech Trainer workspace, click on this, go to monitors. So this is my monitor which I just created. Click on run. Okay, so it has sent the first request. So let us refresh it. Looks like this is green. So let us look at a console log. Okay, it is still working. Let us refresh it again. Let us refresh it again. Okay. Let us click on run once more to see what happens. And let us refresh it. Okay, as you can see, I got the test result. And the test result passed. The status is 200, which is okay. And the response time which I got was 221 milliseconds. Also, you can look at a console log if there are any errors. Let us try once more. Okay, the new request is being sent out. So let us refresh it. Okay, so this also passed. Now if I click on this and go to console log, this 1124, if I click on this, this is 2325. So this also passed. So what it will do is, since I have configured this monitor to run every hour, this is going to run every hour, and then it is going to give me the status as well as average response time. The average response time is 216 milliseconds, which is less than what we have configured. So the status is healthy. So from here, we can continuously monitor those requests and responses for many requests. Since I have only one request which is configured under this collection, so this collection seems to be in good shape. Okay, that is about monitors.
That is the end of today's session. Thanks for watching the video. Have a good day and happy learning.